Indices 2, lecture number 31 is Color and Pigments. Table of Contents. The table of contents of this lecture are Color Basics, Color Perception, Primary Colors of Pigments, Color Theory, and Pigments Category. So in this lecture, you will learn about the basics of colors, what is the perception of color, and which are the primary colors of the pigments, what is color theory, and how pigments are categorized into different categories. You will learn about the inorganic pigments and their types. About pigments. Color basics. Before you embark on selecting colors for handmade or industrial cosmetics, a knowledge based on the fundamentals of color theory and color chemistry is required. So, before you embark on selecting colors for the industrial cosmetics or handmade purposes, it is required that you should have essential knowledge based on the fundamentals of color theory and color chemistry. Electromagnetic radiations. So what are electromagnetic radiations and what is their role? Electromagnetic radiations are the form of energy, and this form of energy is present around us. This form of energy is present in many forms. For example, the radio waves, microwaves, X-rays, and gamma rays. These are our form of energy that is present in many forms around us. You can take an example of electromagnetic radiations as sunlight. So, sunlight is also an example of electromagnetic energy. The visible light is the light that consists of a small portion of the electromagnetic spectrum, and it consists of a broad range of electromagnetic wavelengths. You can see a spectrum of electromagnetic wavelengths which are present in a broad range in these slides. So only certain wavelength of light can be detected by human eyes. So there are certain wavelength of light, and these certain wavelength of lights are detected by the human eye. White light. What is white light and what is the role? So the white light is actually composed of all colors in equal amounts. So the white light is basically composed of the all colors, and these all colors are present in the equal amount. So how we can define the white light? White light is defined as the complete mixture of all of the wavelength of the visible spectrum. This means that if I have a beam of light of all of the colors of the rainbow and focus all of the colors onto a single spot, the combination of all of the colors will result in a beam of white light. You can also see a beam of white light in this slide, and the wavelength of different colors of light. Color perception. So what is color perception and how it works? Specialized cone cells in our eyes respond to visible light and signal color to the brain. So there are some specialized cone cells which are present in our eye. And what is the function of these cone cells? The function of these cone cells is to respond to visible light, and their function is to provide signal color to the brain. So, how color perceptions work? The retina is the back part of the eye, and these retinas contains the cells. And what is the function of these cells? These cells respond to the light. These specialized cells are called as photoreceptors. There are two types of photoreceptors in the retina, rods and cones. Signals from the cones are sent to the brains, which then translate this message into the perception of colors. So how color perceptions work? You can see the diagram in this slide. You can see the retina is present, and this retina is the back part of the eye. There are some special cells, and the retinas consist of the cells, and the function of the cells is to respond the light. You can see how retinas respond to the light. So the special cells which are present in the retinas are called as photoreceptors. So there are two types of photoreceptors are present in the retina. One is the rod and other is the cone. You can see the rod and cone in this slide. The picture on the left hand side shows the retina, and on the right hand side shows the specialized cells which are consist of cone and the rod. So signals from the cones are sent to the brain. When these signals are transferred to the brain, then how brain perform its function? The brain which then translate the message into the perception of color. So that's how the color perception works. What are cone or the cone cells, and what are different kinds of cone cells that are present in birds, dogs, and humans? So birds have different kinds of cones, one in the jaw. So you can see that there are different kinds of cones that are present in the birds. There are four different kinds of cones that are present in the birds. As you can see in this slide, the bird's view, in which you can see that there are different kinds of cones, and these cones are present in the bird. So what are cones or the cone cells? The cone cells or the cones are the photoreceptor cells in the retinas of vertebrate eyes, including the human eye. So the cone cells are the photoreceptor cells that are present in the retina of the vertebrate eyes. These cone cells are present in the retina of the human eye also. The dogs have only two cones, no green. So the dogs have only two, no green. You can see in this slide the dog's view, in which you can see there are two cones that are present in the डॉग्स भी। सो इन डॉग्स देर इज नो ग्रीन इज प्रेजेंट, देर इज नो ग्रीन कॉर्न इज प्रेजेंट। In human view, you can see that the photoreceptor cells which are present in the retina of human eye, and these photoreceptor cells respond differently to the light of different wavelength. As you can see, the wavelength is mentioned in the human view, and when the receptors respond to light of different wavelength, these receptors are thus responsible for color vision. These receptors also function best in the relatively bright light as opposed to the red cell. So this bright light which is opposed to the rod cells which work better in the dim light. Primary colors of the pigments. So which are the primary colors of the pigments? The magenta, cyan and yellow are the primary colors of the pigments. You can see in this slide the yellow color, black, green color, cyan, blue, magenta and red colors are shown. So from all these colors, blue, magenta, red, cyan, green, black and yellow, the magenta, cyan and yellow are the primary colors of the pigments. Adding magenta, cyan and yellow pigments in equal proportions leads to black. So when you add some colors like magenta, cyan and yellow colors in equal proportions, when these colors like magenta, cyan and yellow pigments are added in the equal quantity, these all colors led to the black color. Adding magenta, cyan and yellow pigments in unequal proportions leads to the all possible colors of the pigments. So if we add some colors like magenta, cyan and yellow pigments in unequal distribution or in unequal proportions, these all colors like magenta, cyan and yellow pigments will lead to all possible colors of the pigments. Color theory. What is color theory and which elements are important that leads to understand in the color theory? When evaluating a color for cosmetics, there are three key elements that needs to be considered. So when you evaluate a color for cosmetics, so keep in mind that there are certain factors or the key elements that keep in mind while considering or evaluating the color for cosmetics. These key points which are important are: what is the source of light that the color will be viewed in, natural sunlight or artificial, fluorescent or incandescent. So when you evaluate the color for cosmetics, keep in mind that you should have an idea about the source of light. So what would be the source of light and in which source of light the color will be viewed in? Either the source of light is a natural source or an artificial source. So keep in mind that the sunlight or the fluorescent or the incandescent light is the source. What is the element it is desired for? Lipstick, blush, etc. The second key element in the color theory is that what is the element that is required for certain elements such as lipstick and blush, etc. The third important point in the color theory is that what is the receptor? The human eye for cosmetics. So, while evaluating the color for cosmetics, the third key element that need to be considered is the receptor. So, what is the receptor? The receptor is an organ or cell that able to respond to light, heat, or other external stimulus and transmit a signal to a sensory nerve. So, human eye is the receptor for cosmetics. Pigments category. So, how pigments are categorized into different types? The first one is inorganic pigments. The range of inorganic pigments used in cosmetics is made up of several different chemical types. So, the pigments are categorized into different types. The first type is the inorganic pigments. So, the inorganic pigments are used in the cosmetics. And these inorganic pigments are composed of different chemical types. The inorganic pigments are almost exclusively based on oxide, hydroxide, sulfide, silicate, sulfate, or carbonate. So, the mostly inorganic pigments are composed of oxide, hydroxide, oxide, sulfide, silicate, and the phosphates, etc. These inorganic pigments are classified into the four major groups. And these four major groups are white pigments, black pigments, carbon black, colored pigments, and specially pigments. In general, inorganic pigments are duller in color than their brighter organic counterparts. So, in general, we can see that the inorganic pigments appear duller in color than the organic pigments. The organic pigments are brighter than the inorganic pigments. They are far superior, though, in their stability to heat and light. So, the inorganic pigments are far superior. The inorganic pigments are far superior, though in their stability to respond the heat and the light. So, it is an advantage of an inorganic pigments, because they show stability towards the heat and the light. they can react in extreme conditions of pH. So the inorganic pigments can react in the extreme conditions of pH. So the manufacturing of these materials is very complex, and due to their complexity, they demands rigorous attention to every aspect of manufacturing process, including tightly controlled pH measurement. So during the process of manufacturing of the pigments and the materials, they require extreme conditions of pH. It is very difficult to control the pH measurement. So proper pH control throughout the process is one of the several variables that contribute to the final product quality, as determined by both physical and chemical properties. For example, the ultramarines can react with the acid and produce hydrogen sulfide as a byproduct. It is an inorganic pigment that we most use in cosmetic subjects to their purity levels of heavy metals. So the inorganic pigments can react on extreme conditions of pH. For example, the ultramarines can react with the acids, and when ultramarines react with the acids, they produce the hydrogen sulfide. So hydrogen sulfide is formed as a byproduct in this reaction. So mostly the inorganic pigments are used in the cosmetics, and we use inorganic pigments according to the level of purity, according to the levels of their purity of heavy metals. Inorganic compounds as pigments in the paints. So there are various number of inorganic compounds that are used as the pigments in the paints. Number of inorganic compounds are used as pigments in paints. Many of these compounds are colored due to the absorption of light energy by electrons in d orbital subshells, meaning we see colors depending on which wavelength of light are not absorbed by the compound. So there are number of inorganic compounds that are used as the pigments in the paints. So many of these inorganic compounds are appeared as colored because of the absorption of light energy by the electrons that are present in the d orbital subshells. So that means that we can see different types of colors, and this depends upon the wavelength of light that is not absorbed by the compounds. You can see in this slide that there are number of compounds which are shown. These compounds are used as pigments in the paints. So first compound which is used as the pigments in the paints is carbon black, carbon C. The second compound which is used as the pigments in the paints is titanium dioxide, TiO2, antimony trioxide, SB2O3, zinc oxide, ZnO, The third compound which is shown is cobalt violet. Cobalt 2 phosphate CO3 PO4 taken twice. The fourth compound which is used as the pigments in the paints is ultramarine blue. Na6Al4Si6S4O20. Prussian blue, ferric hexocyanoferrate, Fe6CN taken 18. Cobalt blue, cobalt 2 aluminate CoAl2O4. Cerulean blue, cobalt 2 stannate CO2SnO4. So this is also a compound which is used as a pigment in the paint. Then in the second row, the chrome green is shown. This chrome green is used as a pigment in the paints. This is chromium 3 oxide Cr2O3. Then viridian green is shown. It is hydrated chromium 3 oxide Cr2O into OH taken 4 times. Then cadmium yellow is shown. It is cadmium sulfide CdS chrome yellow lead chromate PbCr4 zinc yellow zinc chromate ZnCrO4. So there is cadmium orange is shown. It is cadmium sulfoselenite CD2SSC. And the last compound which is shown is cadmium prut, cadmium selenide CDSC and red ochre, iron 3 oxide Fe2O3. So these are all our compounds are used as the pigments in the paints. Iron oxides, these inorganic pigments are used in all types of cosmetics and have three basic shades: black, yellow and red. So the iron oxides are used as the pigments in all types of cosmetics, and these iron oxides consist of three basic shades. These shades are black, yellow and red. So their composition is based upon the three colors, which are red, yellow and black. By blending up these oxides in the right proportions, you can produce an array of browns and tans for liquid foundations, face powders and blushes. So when you blend these iron oxides like black, yellow and red colors in right proportions. So when these colors are blended in the right proportions, it produces an array of brown and tans. So due to mixing of these colors, the brown and tans appear, and these colors are used in the liquid foundations, face powders and brushes. By careful blending, an array of natural looking flesh tones may be produced. If we carefully blend these colors like black, yellow and red, you can see that there is an appearance of natural look. So, a flesh tone may be produced by the right blending of these colors. Chromium dioxide. The chromium dioxides are used for most categories of cosmetic preparations but are not permitted for use in lip products in the US. So, the chromium dioxides are mostly used as a pigments in the preparation of cosmetics. But in some countries like the United States of America, USA, the chromium dioxide products are permitted to use in the lip products. So, in USA, the chromium dioxide is permitted for use in lip products. Green range from dull olive green to a blue green or bright green. So, the chromium dioxide pigments colors ranges from the dull olive green to a blue green or bright green. You can also see in this slide a picture is shown which shows the color of the chromium dioxide. It appears as a blue green or the bright green or the dull olive green color. Assignments. Assignment number 1 is how color perception works. Assignment number 2 is which inorganic compounds are used as pigments in paints.